264 people died in 7 commercial airplane accidents in the U.S. in 1994. While the National Transportation Safety Board is still investigating some of those crashes, the federal government, the airline industry, and union officials have come up with 173 initiatives to improve safety. They came out of a January meeting in Washington.
We think that last month's conference might be viewed as a real turning point in the way we view aviation safety.
Among the proposals, more use of simulators for advanced pilot training, expanded qualifications and schooling for mechanics, better use of satellite systems for navigation and airport approaches, and new technology to cut down on runway accidents. Plus, as of next month, commuter airlines, which operate aircraft with more than 9 seats, will have to follow the same safety standards as the larger carriers. But perhaps the biggest change? Increased recording of flight data to be shared with the entire industry.
I think this will be an enormous benefit in helping us predict potential problems when they have not yet occurred. And in that sense, we hope we can avoid a potential accident in the future.
That is also the hope of every airline passenger. In fact, each person who buys a ticket in this country pays a tax, which is supposed to go into an aviation trust fund. That fund currently has more than $3.7 billion from 4 different taxes.
That fund could be used for a lot of things. One, of course, would be wind shear. There's a lot of airports around the country that do not have the latest wind shear information system, the Doppler radar.
Pittsburgh is one of only 15 airports whose Doppler radar has been installed. Contractors have been working since 1988 to put the system into 47 of the country's 417 FAA-towered facilities. Charlotte, where wind shear caused this crash last July, isn't scheduled for delivery of its Doppler radar until December. Kathy Barnsdorf, 13 News.